Hello everyone. So in this video, we are going to learn about how to sort a CSV file. Okay, let's get started. The problem statement is sort Excel CSV file utility reads a file of records, sorts them and then write back to the file. Allow the user to choose various sort styles and sorting based on a particular field. So what you will be doing is we'll need a CSV file, then we will read the file from the records and then sort the content and then write back to another file, another CSV file, right? So this is our problem statement. So what is CSV? CSV basically stands for comma separated values. So it is basically a type of file that is having entities, that is having columns and rows, and each column is separated with a comma. It may be a tab, it may be a space, it may be a semicolon, it may be a pipe or something like that, all that. So okay, and the each row is a new line. So this is what we call a CSV file, and then this is how a CSV file looks like. So these are all our rows, and each column is separated with a comma here. Okay, so it can be separated with semicolon, it can be separated with tab, it can be separated with space, or it can be separated with a pipe sign. Okay, so it can be you can use any one of them, not a problem at all. So it's basically depend on you how we'll use that. Okay, so this is how a file looks like. The very first row is the heading, and then all other are datas. Okay, and let's see how it will work. So for reading a file, we will first store as file object the file in the file object. Okay, file, file, and then we will be using CSV module to read a file as a csv.reader and then file, and then to write the into the file we will be using csv.writer method and the file object itself, and the mode should be here write mode, and the mode here should be read mode. Okay, or it can be append mode here if you want to append something of the on the CSV file. Okay, so delimiters are like the signs you are using for separating the columns. So as you have told earlier, it can be a tab, it can be a comma, it can be a space, it can be a semicolon, or it can be a pipe sign. Okay, so whatever you like you can use. So this is how we'll be reading a CSV file. First we'll import CSV module, then we'll open our file as a reading in the reading mode, and then we will store it in the file object, and then we will use csv.reader file and store it in the reader object, and then we will iterate through the reader and it will print each row. So what it does here is it will iterate through each row of the CSV file. Okay, so this way we'll be reading the file and it will print the content of the CSV file. And how we'll be writing the file? So as earlier, we'll first import CSV module, then open the file in write mode. And what new line is? New line is basically while we are writing in the file, so we don't want to be empty space in between the lines. So if I don't use new line here, new line and the space here, so it will make blank spaces in between the lines. So I don't want that. So to prevent that problem, we'll be using new line, and then we will store our file file in the file object, and then we will be using csv.writer file and then put it in the writer object. And then if after writing the file, we will be using write row method here, like here, and the number of rows we want to print, we will each time we will be using write row method like this. First is the heading, the second is the data, the third is the data, and the fourth is also data. Okay, so one thing here is that if I want to print various rows simultaneously, okay, consecutively, I don't want to use write row again and again, I just will use write rows instead of write row. Okay, so and in that we have to pass nested list. So what I will pass in that is first row, comma, second row, comma, third row, comma, fourth row, and all of that inside a bigger list. Okay, so we'll be just as a passing it a nested list. Okay, so the sorting will work like this. So like when we'll be reading from a CSV file, we will store it in a nested list. Okay, we'll store our file in a nested list like this one here. Okay, then we will use a sorting function and then pass our nested list here to sort, and then key will define according to which column we have to sort it. So if I want to sort it according to the first column of each list, list one, list two, list three here. So if I want to sort according to the first column, so I will pass key as zero here. If I want to sort according to the second column, I will pass key here as one. Okay, so because zero and one, because the indexing start from zero in Python. Okay, so what is it doing? It is basically x is representing the list inside list here. So x is representing this list, and this list, not complete list out of there. It is representing the inside list. Okay, so the inner list. So x1 represents here the second column element. So it will sort the nested list according to the second column. So second column is A, C, B, and A. Okay, so the first one will be according to alphabetical sorting. The first one will be A, then second one will be B, then the third one will be C. Okay, so and then finally we will be having our sorted list, and then we'll print it, and the output is something like that. As you will see, the first one is according to the A, the second one is B, the third one is C. So it has sorted, and the complete list here we are getting. So in this way we have sorted our list. Okay, and the module we'll be using here is CSV module. Okay, it's time to code something and let's see how it works. So as you will see here, first of all we will import our CSV module, and then we will having a function sort CSV for sorting the CSV file. Okay, and then we will be having our main function. So whatever I will be using, I will define it first in the main function and then call the sort CSV function from the main function itself. Okay, so let's see how it will be working. So as you will see, the first one line is with opens char CSV as read mode. So as I've told you earlier, the first for reading the file, first we will open it in read mode, and then okay, let's first see how will be working inside this one. So the first is the read, and then we have first open the so the CSV file I'm using here is having the delimiter as semicolon. So I have to specify. So default is the comma. So if you don't specify the delimiter, is expecting the delimiter as to be a comma. But first you have to see what the delimiter has been used in the CSV file so that you get the right delimiter here. Okay, so as not to get the wrong results. So if you do not use the right delimiter, it will get you the wrong results. So first you have to see whether you are using the right delimiter or not. So if the comma is CSV in CSV file is used, so you don't have to specify because the default is the comma. So but if it is any other thing except the comma, so you have to specify the delimiter. So in my CSV file, I'm using delimiter as semicolon, so I have to specify here semicolon. Okay, so CSV read, and I've read the file in the read object, and then I will first okay neglect this one right now, right, neglect this one. First I will convert the read object into a list. So it will convert my CSV file, my CSV data inside a nested list. So list read. Okay, and the first one, as I told you, the first one is the okay, let me show the CSV file. So it is a CSV file. The first is the heading. Okay, so as you will see, the car, MPG, cylinder, displacement, all that I've shown you in the presentation. The first one is the heading, and all other lines are data. So the very first line, so zeroth row, is the heading. So I've put it in the heading itself. Okay, so it's a list, and then we will be using select one of the column to sort accordingly. So I want to select here that according to which column you want to sort the file. You want to sort according to the car column, you want to sort according to the MPG, cylinder, displacement, horsepower, whatever column you like, you can select here. Okay, so whichever you like. And then I equals to zero, and then for each in heading. So I have just heading I have used so as to print all the choices. So as you can select which one row. Okay, so this is basically printing each heading, each column of the heading, right? And then it will enter your choice in the n. Okay, another thing here is I have to take the value also. So as you will see in the CSV file, we are having a string as well as floating values. The first one is, like, you will see it is a string. The second one is the floating value. The third one is, and up to here, all are floating or integer values. So I cannot sort the all according to the string. So I have to specify whether it is a string or is it integer or anything else. But right now here all the data is a string right now. So all the data, as you can specify here, as you will see here. So all the data is a string right now, but it is not seeing. I know it is not visible that it is a string because it's not inside the commas. Inside the, okay, so but let me tell you, all the data is a string right now. Okay, so that's why we have to specify whether it is a string we are taking according to the column or it is an integer. So we have to specify, then we will pass the value, the it is an integer or a string, and then the column number according to which we have to sort it. Okay, let's see our sorting function, how we'll be using that one. Okay, so first we will be having two list, sorted list and heading list. So in the sorted list, we will pass all our data inside, all our sorted data inside a sorted list, and the first column, first row as the heading inside the heading. Okay, so there are two things. First we will open the file as a read mode. So we'll inside this one, we will be reading our file. This one, inside this one, we'll be reading our file and then sorting it and then storing it in the sort. And then in the second one, we will be storing it in the another CSV file, that is sorted CSV, and we will open this one as a reading mode. Okay, writing mode, sorry. Let's see this one first. In this one, as usual, we have first open the CSV file as using csv.reader, and the delimiter, as I told you earlier, is semicolon in this CSV file, and then we will read list, and then we will for as to pass our nested list inside the read list, we have to first typecast the read object here. Okay, then we will be passing the first row inside the heading. Okay, so we are done with here. Now we'll sort our list. So first is value is zero. So value zero means that the according to here, the value zero means it's a string, and the value one means it is an integer. And then we will use our sorted function here. Okay, so we'll pass our read list from the second row, because the first row is the heading, so we don't want to sort that. So we will pass all the elements after the first row. Okay, so because the index start from 0, the second row will begin with 1. Okay, so 1 specify the second row here, and the key will be passing as the as I have told you earlier. So the it will be the inner list, it will be x signifies the inner list, and the nth column of that list. So whatever I have passed here, so it will sort according to that. So if it is a string, so it is a string, so it will sort accordingly, and the value, if the value is 1, it will first convert that that particular column inside the floating value if it is not a string, and then it will sort according to that. Okay, and now We will print the sorted list so as to see if the correct sorted list is there or not. Okay, so this is simple, nothing new in that one. And then we will write the sorted list inside the our sorted csv.csv file. So first of all, we use csv.writer here. Okay, and then you'll be using a writer object dot write row and is the method, and we'll pass the heading list here first. So as I want to the in the sorted CSV file also, I want to have the first row to be the heading itself. We don't want the data from the very first line. We want the first line as to be the heading. Okay, so the second after that we will be writing, as you I have told you earlier, if I want to pass the all the rows at once, so I will be using a write rows method. If I want to print only one row at a time, so I will use a write row method only. So in the write row method I pass the list, but in the write rows method I pass the nested list. So sorted list is a nested list here. Okay, so that much is it for this, and then now let's try to run it if it runs correctly or not. Okay, let's check. So I will run this one. Okay, let's run it. So it's asking for the column which I want to use. I want to sort it according to the first column first. Okay, so the first column is a string, so I will pass 0, and then it has sorted accordingly. So as you will see, the car CSV file is the first column you will see. So it is not sorted like you see C B P A F F C. It is not sorted. Okay, but if you see here, so it looks like it's sorted. It's sorted like this one. Okay, so as you will see, the first all A, then B, then C, then D, C here, B, F, H, M, and all that. Okay, so it's look like it's sorted. Fine. And let's try to sort it according to let's say the last element. Okay, let's try to run it. The last element is origin. Okay, 8 we are sorting, and again is an integer, so we'll sort according to that. As you will see, the last element is U. Okay, and the previous elements are J and then E, and you will see. Okay, so it's look like it's sorted. And now use some integer. Now we'll be using some other values, other columns. Let's write according to the second one. First one, let's try first one, MPG according to the MPG. Okay, and that's a integer value, not a string. Okay, so I will pass 1, and it has sorted according to this one. So as like let's see. Has gone. Okay, so it starts from here. So the first is 0, and then 0, then 0, then 0, then 0, and then 9, 10, 11, 11, 12, 12, 12, 13. So it looks like it's correctly sorted. Okay, so this one's correct, working fine. And let's look at the sorted our sorted CSV file. So it looks like it's sorted. Okay, so we have written the content in the sorted list, sorted CSV file also. So let's see. The first is 0, then 0, then 0, 0, 0, 0, and then 0. Okay, not 117. 117 belongs to the first column. 0, 0. And then 9, then 10, then 10, 11, 11, 11, 11, 12, 12, 12, 12, 13, 13, 13, 13, and okay, it's sorted, right? So we won't be looking to the all the contents, so because the total number of contents here are 407 contents, and minus 1 because the first one is heading, to 406 total number of rows we are having as our content. Okay, so that's it for this video. I hope now you can sort a CSV file by yourself. So thank you very much.